Welcome to Las Vegas, Nevada. I'm Trunkhead with Trunkhead Gaming. Today I'll be doing an REL Division 6 matchup. Owns Berserkers versus Stouticus' what was the name of these guys? The Wooden Stand-ins. I'm gonna be real honest, I didn't even know we had six divisions. Fucking had no clue. But I was talking to this guy, this coach owned, and he mentioned that he had this game coming up. This is the 1-2 teams in Division 6. This is a very important matchup. There's only 1 point separating these two. And, of course, there's a playoff spot on the line. So it's very important to both coaches. Division 6, I don't know a lot about any of these coaches. That doesn't mean they're not good. I mean, there's, you know, Division 6 is where you come up and you'll have coaches who've been playing Blood Bowl 1 or been playing tabletop their whole lives and just getting into the online scene. Just getting into league play, we've been playing ladder for a long time, and there's coaches that are new to the game. But it's just because they're in Division 6 doesn't mean they're not good. And these two coaches apparently are very good because they're on top of the division. So let's go over their squads real fast. I'm going to stop the moving around real fast. So the Wooden Stand-ins, this is the number one team. They're up by 1 point. I did what I wasn't supposed to do. Anyway, you got the level one Woodman Treeman, and there go all the skills. So they got the rookie lineman. They got dodge on these two linemen, which I love. I love dodge on elf linemen. This guy's got dodge too. Like, this is a pretty well built together wood elf team. War dancers, strip ball, tackle, and this guy's got mighty blow, and he's move 9. Fucking sick. This guy's awesome with blodge step. And then you got a catcher, a blodge catcher, with with move 9. So these guys are fast, and he's got 3 guard elves. So he can do bash pretty well. That's a pretty impressive fucking elf team right here. He's going to enjoy this while it lasts, having all these skills on these line elves. Wood elf linemen don't last very long as he moves up in the divisions. And then over here, this is Owens Berserkers, number 2 place elf. There's a lot of really good dwarf teams in the Rebel this year. I mean, both G-Man and REL have some good squads. There is a block fend move 7 runner, which I love. And then over here, he's got strip ball. He's got block strip ball. I'd like to see this. If he's going to do the strip ball, the sacker, which is awesome for one runner to be a sacker and one runner to be a blocker, he should have done wrestle instead of block. Over here, block, I mean, guard. He's got tons of guard. This berserker's got tackle. I like tackle. This patrol slayer, excuse me. He's got, I like the mighty blow tackle. Because he can, like, hunt skinks, for instance, or he can hunt linemen, line elves, or war dancers. This guy's unskilled. Guard, mighty blow. Guard, and guard, mighty blow. I think he's got 2 guard, mighty blow elves, line elves. I'd like to see this next guy with guard. These two guys, I'd like to see them both go stand firm. And then he can go back to mighty blow. And then his blitzers are kind of undeveloped, which is actually not surprising. When I played my dwarves, I had problems with, because you don't use them to they're blitzers, but you don't use them to blitz that often, because you use your troll slayers to blitz. So the benefit to these guys is, A, they're move 5, so they're a step faster than these guys, and they're B, they're AG3, which, so they can kind of count as stand-in runners if you happen to lose your runner or need to hand off. The AG3 helps them out. They're a little more mobile. But they're hard to level, because you don't really use them that often. You don't blitz them that often. You don't really run with them that often. So they always develop kind of slow. So this guy's got guard, and guard on dwarfs is always good. But I wouldn't mind seeing Mighty Blow first on blitzers, because they can start to build on their own. If you get a guy with blitz with a Mighty Blow, then they can get his own injury SPP. So the Wooden Stand-ins won the toss, and they chose to kick. Elves almost always choose to kick because they want to have as many guys as possible on defense. So he went with a safe dive defense. I know the owned bot. All right, so get the ref. So they both get a bribe. I know the owned bought the bribe stadium. We got the referee rest area. So both teams had a bribe already. And then Owen bought, with his inducements, because he was the underdog, he bought bribes. So with the event, he's got 3 bribes, and then 2 for Stouticus. Fouling is better for dwarfs than it is for elves, because elves are AB7 and dwarfs are AB9. So it's hard to foul AB9, and they're always stick together, so it's hard to get assists on them. So he started with the Troll Slayer there. Got the KO, and then another. He's got two armor breaks to start off. I might have started with, had one of these guys hit, and then. So what I'm trying to say is, I might have had this Longbeard hit that first line elf, and then this Longbeard hit his line elf, because I'd want this guy who did the blitz, because he's got Dauntless, right? There's a chance that he triggers his Dauntless and gets to knock down this tree. Instead of moving this guy in. So. He's going to come up and get on that guard elf. I would love to hit these guard elves. I think it's just get this mighty blow, and this guard elf is good. You get the guard guys off the pitch, you're doing really, really well. And another armor break, just a stun. So three hits, you got a KO and two stuns. That's going to happen against AV7. You have turns like that. Stouticus probably doesn't like it very much. he's getting enough assists on this tree to fucking get a hit on him. And he knocks him down. So this tree has a 4 plus to stand up. And the reason that happens is because he's moved 2. And you need 2 movement to stand up. So what they basically say is, since he's used all of his movement to stand up, otherwise he wouldn't be able to get up. They make it a 4 plus. That's the rule. So the sacker gets the ball, and we'll do a light cage on him. I'd be nervous about this cage. I'd be nervous about this cage because these elves are really fast, and they can get around to you. I might have wanted to use some of these dudes up here to come back and protect them a little bit. You have to cage tight against fucking elves, unless they fucking 1 in 36 their first dodge. Then your life is pretty good. That's not a good start for Stouticus. He's got to be pretty unhappy about that. He had 4 guys knocked down. 3 of them had armor breaks. 1 was a KO. And then your first move, before you even do any actions, you fucking 1 in 36. And you burn a reroll. So Owen's going to get over here, and he's going to cage up. And he's got guard on both corners. This is perfect. If you're a Stouticus and you're attacking dwarves, when I attack dwarves, I always want to attack the runners and the troll slayers because they're AV8. So you got 4 pieces that are AV8. You really want to get them. Going to blitz with his mighty blow piece again. I like this. Get the push. But the push is okay because he can foul this guard piece, which I would absolutely do. I'm going to bring this guard. Well, I'd have brought him up for the assist. 1, 2, 3, 4. I'd have put in a GFI, so I get it. But he should foul this piece right here. And he should have used more assists, is what I'm saying. But he's AV7, so this is probably a pretty good foul. You can't see the percentages in the replay, so you don't know. But he gets stomped with the beard mug there by the Troll Slayer. Even though you have bribes, you should not use your positional pieces to foul with. You should use linemen, because the bribe does fail 1 in 6 times. Gonna go up and get this guard piece involved. Stouticus standing up his elves. Sometimes elves don't stand up. Here comes the Mighty Blow War Dancer. Let's see what he's got on him. He gets 2 dice on Thor. Thor the Blitzer with guard, and only a touchdown away from leveling. Hopefully he can get a level this game. Get a touchdown and get a level. Just gets a knockdown, no stun. I'd be surprised if he doesn't get fouled, actually. One of these, probably this elf right here. Or this elf right here. Elf coaches generally are not good at fouling, even when they have bribes, unless they're really experienced playing other races, because elves in general don't foul. And the reason they don't foul is because their linemen are so fucking expensive. They're $70,000, so if you lose an lineman, it hurts. And elves don't generally have a bench. Stouticus has a bench. He's got a runner, catcher over there. Rookie catcher. But they don't generally have a bench because they lose pieces. And then you can't afford to foul when you have no bench or a light bench. So they're not very practiced at it. That's what I'm trying to say. Slow and steady down moves the race. Make sure you have guard pieces on this fucking cage at all times. I think this is good. And hit this guard piece. I like hitting the guard piece with the Mighty Blow. You should always put the Mighty Blow. No armor break there. But you gotta keep hitting AV7 with Mighty Blow for sure. He's looking for a surf opportunity over here, and he kind of has one. If he can push this guy forward, I mean, not right this turn. If this guy stays up, push this guy forward and get it. You got to be careful. This guy doesn't have to worry about me and talking surf because he's got – this is a sick war dancer. If this guy's got a sidestep. Otherwise, he's going to be looking for the surf. Blitzer takes it in the chin. Has a cool little spin kick from this guy, Magnum, or Morgan Freeman. Morgan Freeman. I'm guessing that these are Samuel Elm Jackson, Benedict Cumberbatch. These are cool fucking names, Stouticus. So they're trees with their trees and actor mixes. Tree and actor puns. Benedict Cumberbatch, that's funny. Odin is going to get kicked by a tree. That doesn't feel very good. That guy's fucking foot is as big as that dwarf is. And so he goes down. And he gets armor broke. One of two mighty blows is that tree. So he's got a couple assists right there. And he's going to hit him with his troll slayer, hopefully, because he's got a chance. It's like a five or a six to get the Dauntless. Oh, he's going to blitz. He's going to blitz the tree. I wouldn't have blitzed the tree. I don't like that blitz. Because you already had a guy in contact with him. You could have had three hits at him. I don't mind assisting him there. Sounds like when you hear that sound, the timer is actually going. And so you know that he's trying to hurry up and finish his turn right here. Kind of left an opening right here, right? See if Stouticus attacking a cage of dwarves is really hard for, especially with all these guards. So he's trying to pick off dwarves. But he's doing a good job. Like, he's got this elf screen. These dwarves are stuck in. This is why I don't like going on the sideline as dwarves, because he doesn't have a whole lot of options right here. He's just got to fight his way through. And it's turn four. Like, he's only got four turns left. He needs to start making some headway. And he hasn't removed any elves. He's got these three brides, but he's only done one foul in four turns. So I'd like to have seen Owen get some of these fucking fouls in. Hey, you have three of them. Start fucking beating on elves. I mean, at this point, it doesn't matter what you beat on. Beating on fucking guard pieces, beating on dodge pieces, it doesn't matter. But anyway, so what I was trying, when dwarves pick a side, they get hemmed in just like this. And then they don't really know what to do. All they got to do is fight the way through. I like to just fucking beef it right up the middle. Just line up and then go. And sometimes you have turns where you don't even move. But you have eight turns to get down there. And then the reason you do that is because when you get down in the middle here, if you need to take a break to the right or left, you have options. You come down the side, you have no options. Your option is to keep going straight. So I think he's going to fucking foul this tree, which I love. I'd even bring that guy in for an assist. Make sure he's got this cage corner. I missed the blitz there. I was talking about dwarf tactics. cage is up strong. He only has one guard piece on his corner cage, which means they can cancel these two assists, and then this guy can leap in. The strip ball doesn't do any good because of the sure hands. There's the leap, which fails. I love watching fucking Wood Elf fail their leap. And the reason I love watching Wood Elf fail their leaps is because I fucking hate Wood Elves. He goes in, gets the one die, and gets the pow. Secret Blood Bowl story. I don't know if you guys are aware of this. Every time a fucking Wood Elf War Dancer jumps into a cage, he's going to pow you. It doesn't matter what skills you have, you're going to get powed. I know that because every Wood Elf who's ever caged over me has fucking powed me. So that feels bad. And now the ball is surrounded by fucking elves. He's trying to clear these spots so he can get in with these superior AG and pick this ball up. I'd have gone for it right there. He might bring this catcher in. Push this dwarf out of the way. Now there's only one tackle zone on there. This guy's going to come over here and pick up this ball and fucking zoom away. Except for he fucking snake. He rolled a one. But that's an excellent fucking bounce for him. Right now, Owen's pissed because it's his drive and he just lost the ball. And the ball's in a fucking terrible spot. So he needs to make good use of this. This is Zirkin. He gets two dice on this guy. This guy doesn't have tackle. I would not push him onto the ball right here because this guy's got three guys who can catch it. Because they're elves, they're likely to catch it. Morgan Freeman is off the pitch. Getting a guard piece off the pitch is good. He's going to hit this fucking War Dancer, and he needs to stomp on this War Dancer. He gets this done. I would still stomp on this War Dancer. War Dancer's on the ground. I'm going to stop it real quick. Before you do anything else, I would stomp on this War Dancer. I would take the risk that you're not going to 1 in 6 the fucking bribe. And I clear this guy. Boom, clear him. And then I would stomp on him with this guy. You have to fucking hit war dancers when on the dirt, especially when you have three bribes. Clear this fucking guy. Stomp on him right there. Right there. That's what I want to see you do, won't. Fucking get that guy. Pushes that guy back, so maybe he is. Maybe that's exactly what he's doing. Clear that dude. Oh, he should have moved him down here, though, if he wanted to foul. Because this guy's canceling. He's canceling that assist right now. Unlucky there on the two die. I mean, you had a pretty good chance to knock that guy down and don't do it. I like how he's not knocking him onto the ball because he knows that the ball is likely to bounce into the hands of an elf. Here goes the foul, which I love. And failed the armor break. And if you notice that, let's just stop this for fucking 1 second. So he rolled a 6 and he needed a 7. If he had taken this guy and pushed him back here and this guy was clear, that would have broke armor. just saying, if this guy wasn't in contact with canceling this assist, that 6 would have broke armor. So there you go. So now he's going to frenzy onto the ball because he doesn't have block and the ball bounces into a bad spot because it's got nowhere else to bounce other than a bad spot. Pow him though, that's good. Dwarfs, unknown fact, are not good at dodging. but he's got reroll, so he uses it. He needs to keep fouling, man. You got three bribes. Use them. Beating elves involves making them roll dice. So now he's out of rerolls. Because he, especially unskilled, well, elves that don't have dodge, you need to make them roll dodges. You have to. Benedict Cumberbatch is going to throw the ball, and now the dwarves are in trouble. That guy's tackled, though. I don't even know where the fuck that was. So he's got to get over. He's got to stop this goal. He's probably not going to score himself now, but he needs to get over here and stop this goal. And this is why you have these move five fucking thrower or blitzers. So I'll just see who he's going to blitz with. I think he'll blitz with this guy. Oh, he dubbed skull there. That uses a reroll. Doesn't feel good. I would not have used that. Let me just tell you why I wouldn't have done that. I would have taken this guy, this guard piece, and put him right here on the 6. Because then this guy, then you can attack this guy instead, and you'll serve him right off the, whoop, right off the pitch. Instead of this guy. And then he's guaranteed off the pitch. Takes an extra piece to do it. Then this guy can hit this dude, which will push him that way. Yep, that's what I would have done. So anyway, he did different. Marking war dancers does 0 good unless it happened to 1 in 36. There you go, get the tackle piece on him. He can still just leap away. So I wouldn't invest too many pieces in guarding him. He needs to get. Who's he gonna put over there? It's gonna be. See, I'm coming with this guy, right? The strip ball. That's why you have him. I love this. I love it. I love it. I love it. Hit that fucking war dancer. Keep. Oh, the referee. Hey, ref. Here's some money, ref. Get out of here. This is all well done. He's going to serve him from this way, so that's okay. It worked out perfect for him. Oh, snap. Kill the guard piece. If you ever watched Soss, or Sace, sorry, he hates elves with fucking guard. Yeah, because I had 4 of them. He helped kill a couple of them. Perfect. Get the pow. Robert Dogwoody. He's going to fucking hit the dirt. Ball goes in a okay spot. He's going to bring this guy over because he's got movement. Put him in scoring position, I'm guessing. Yeah, that's perfect. This is really well done. So now he can get the ball, hand it off to him, and he can go score, right? 2, 4, 6, 7, 8 with the GFI. You got to reroll. So you're good. This guy's going to get away and try to pick up this ball. Oh, he's going to guard that guy. Now you have to put some from here. Ooh, really unfortunate for the Samuel Elm Jackson. I would still fucking... I would still, before I did anything else, pound this guy. I'd bring all these dudes down here, pound this guy. So I don't know what his plan is. Looks like he's going to do the blitz first. I like that. That's fine. That'll work. The dwarfs come with block built in. So now, before I went and scored, I would bring every single free... Well, I would attack with this guy and see if I can knock down this war dancer. And if I can, maybe I go up there and foul him because he's more valuable. And if I don't knock him down, all these guys come down here, assist, and I foul this guy. And then I go score. Like, I would take that risk. Let's see what he ends up doing here. He's going for a three die, and that's War Dancer. I don't hate it. You don't get the fouling if you do it that way, but I don't hate it. Now he's just marking up pieces. We should always do this in case your plan goes wrong. You want to mark as many pieces as possible. He should have stayed marked on this guy, though. But this guy can't. None of these guys can score, so this doesn't really matter. Gets the knockdown. But you have nobody left to foul him. You have to foul him with this guy. He's going to unassisted. Well, one assist. But he's only 8v7, so, I mean, he's still a good referee. He's on point right now. Fortunately, that bribe works. Pick it up, hand it off. This is all well done. All you need is GFI. That was a good recovery from Owens. It was really good getting the ball out by Stouticus. Oh, shit, tripwire. That's why you got to reroll. Hopefully, you don't want a 36 here. All right. That's really well done by both coaches. Stouticus got that ball out. He's had him penned in, got the ball out, and made him run for it. It's too bad he didn't have somebody else there besides that guard guy. But I don't know that he had any other choices. So that was, if you're the Dwarfs, that is about perfect. You use your entire drive. Now you have to stop the one-turner. And he's got fucking two awesome one-turners. This guy's awesome, and this guy's awesome. This guy actually only needs one push. Because he's got fucking sprint. He's move 9. Oh, once that guy gets sure feet, he's going to be nasty. He needs sidestep and sure feet. And that guy is just going to be gross. So he only needs one push. So this is an awesome one-turn defense. It's a little bit harder. I'm going to stop right here. It's a little bit harder when you don't have a strength 5 piece or a stand firm piece. Like, if this guy had stand firm, one of these guard dwarfs needs stand firm. This is the guy. This is where you put the stand firm, right here. But he doesn't have stand firm, so you need to double this up. This needs to be two guys. Or a strength 5 guy. You don't have a strength 5 guy. The other problem is this guy here has grab. So this becomes kind of irrelevant. Because of this tree. This tree can literally hit this dude and push him right there, which is what he'd want to do. Because he needs to fill the... Because he's going to do the one-turner, Stouticus has to fill this gap right here. And because this guy's got grab, he can just fucking pop him, throw him over there. So the grab nullifies this, and this guy needs to be either strength 5 or stand firm. If he had stand firm, the grab wouldn't matter. He could just fucking stay right there. So we'll see if this works. All the tackles is really going to help him. He wants to make sure the guard pieces are on the interiors. This is perfect. Guard and tackle. I like all that. He wants tackle in here. And this guy, he wants tackle with too. The guys on the corners. You should put long beards in the corner with tackle. Because the ball runner, the ball carrier is going to get out over here. He's going to have to go through these tackle zones. So this is... kind of well done. It's a great idea. This is the best kind of one-turn defense. Like I said, this guy having grab. It looks like Stouticus is... He's going to take this grab piece and throw him in here. And he's going to go throw him in here, and he's going to push everybody this way. These guys really need tackle on the wings. So let's see what Stouticus does here. My guess is... So he's going to take... Oops. Hit the fucking button in time. Oh, that makes a difference. This is minus 1 passing rolls. Very sunny. Especially since Stouticus has no rerolls left. So he's going to take this grab piece to die. He's going to throw him right in here. Okay. He's got to stand right here to do this. So you can't blitz and then grab. So you're going to hit this guy, and you're going to throw him right there. And then he needs to take this War Dancer, and he needs to leap into this spot. Excuse me, he needs to go in this spot. He doesn't need to fill this spot. He needs to fill this spot. So he's going to take this guy. He's going to throw him here. And then he's probably going to either take this War Dancer and leap into this spot, or he's going to come around. No, this guy's got to hit him. So he could use this guy to come around here and get into this spot. He's going to have to use the War Dancer. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah, he's going to have to either do a dodge. He's going to have to do a, was it a 3 plus dodge or a 4 plus, 3 plus dodge. And this guy had tackle, it would be harder. Or he's going to have the War Dancer come over here and leap into it. Because he needs to fill this gap, because this guy's going to be here. And then he can push him, leave this spot open, and this spot open, push him here. He only needs one push, right? No, he needs 2 pushes. He only needs 1 push. You can push him right there, and then he can go. And then it's 2, 4, 6, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Yep. So that's what he needs. He needs to fucking grab this guy, push him into here, bring this War Dancer, leap him into right there. And then this guy, well, he needs to fill this gap too. He needs to fill both his gaps. This is a really good one-turn defense. Like I said, it's working out really well for him. Let's see what he does. Gives it to the one-turner guy, of course. Leaps to fill the gap. He did a leap blitz. He's pushing him there. Okay. Fills a gap there. Pushes. Oh, he skulls. Holy shit. Oh, that was actually going to work. He did everything he needed to do, and his fucking tree rolled 2 skulls and a double down, and he had no rerolls. Oh, Stouticus, that was so well done, dude. Oh, fuck. Oh, man, that was impressive. That was really impressive by Stouticus. And he got it. That fucking didn't pay him off. So that went perfectly if you're owned. It could not have gone better. That was fucking, I'm impressed by Stouticus right there. Like I said, the War Dancer doing the leap, and that worked out really well. And like I said, he could have grabbed him too. Grabbed him and pushed him with the tree. Well, I guess he couldn't have. I think he had to do it that way. He had to do this way because he had to push with the tree. So he could have put the tree here. Put the tree here, and when he hit this guy, pushed him in this way, and then followed him. So another way to do it, but that was sick. That was sick done, and then that tree fucking failed him. Man, that's brutal. So if you're playing elves, you have to protect the wings. But what I don't like about this is all of his guys are up front. And if you don't know if War Dancers have leap, he'll just fucking come over here and leap over these guys, and he'll be gone. That's the only thing I don't like about this. I mean, there's not really a better way to do it. You want this screen. Like, this is good. I like to have these guys in the corner. I like them to have tackle so that people can't just cruise right by here on 3 pluses. This guy does have tackle. This guy doesn't. But I'd like this to be back a little farther. Come back like one or two. Like, your front guys should be here or here. And then your back guys will be back here. Because if you get too close, they can use very little movement to get to you, and then jump over you, and then the rest of their movement to get away. But yeah, so anyway, I know I've tried to complete the stop 4 times. You're the dwarves. You use the entire fucking turn, the entire half. To use up, and you didn't counterscore. You got 1 death. You got 1 removal. You really wanted another, but he fouled plenty. Even though I was talking about turn 4 like Falmore, he kept fouling on. He still got a bribe. Elves will have both their bribes. Now, the Stouticus only needs to... a tie here keeps him in his number 1 spot, so he doesn't need to fucking push. Most Wood Elf coaches do push because they're so fast. They just try and score. That's probably a mistake here. He needs to kind of stall out, which means that Owen sort of needs to push him and make him score fast. Owen wants to push him and make him score as fast as possible, right? So that he has plenty of time to equalize. He's gonna cage up because he's scared of the mighty, mighty dwarf cage dive. Comes a mighty blow blitz on the kick piece. That's not the piece I would have chosen, but he dubs gold. He chose not to reroll there. I think that's a good choice. I mean, yeah, it sucks. It's your first action, your first turn. But you still have a whole half, to go, so you need those. That's a wise decision not to reroll there. It's very unfortunate. I guess the pow on Apollo. Apollo, the strip ball guy. And he definitely wants to get this guy off the pitch. Because there is no sure hands over here on the dwarf side at all. So getting that strip ball piece off is paramount. So if you're owned, this is not bad. I mean, it looks like Stouticus is he's behind you, and that sucks. But you know, he's Wood Elves. He's going to fucking score. If you can stop a Wood Elf offense, more power to you. Especially as dwarfs. So you want to... Now he just needs to crash this corner and keep pressure on him. Like, I'm sort of surprised that Stouticus didn't just put his fucking runner back here with the ball and then play around for a long, nice time and then just come up and score. Score in the last turn. I'm surprised he put the ball in jeopardy. Unless his plan is to score fast, which it might be. Score fast, get the ball back, because he got the ball out the first time. He could easily do it again. And if he wins, if he beats Owned, if Stouticus wins, then he cements his position, right? Like, he doesn't have to worry about next week, because he's won the series. You got three bribes, so foul that guy. That's the only guy you're worried about. Stouticus needs to get all these dwarves over here that are out of the play into the play. Who does he want? This guard piece is fucking pissing him off, I'm sure. Especially since that's a one die right now. I'd still take that one die. Oh, it is two die, good. Because of this guard piece. Gets the block, knocks him down. You wanted to push him there, so you got the assist here. And you did, so. Block doesn't do you any good. Skull, you rerolled that one die skull, I like that. Get that guy out of the way, get a body on the ball carrier. Even if it's really unlikely anything happens, unlikely things happen. Look at that fucking dwarf dodge over there. This is the Blitzer, man. Blitzer's AG3. Did that dodge with no rerolls, too. War Dancer pops him. And then runs away. Because that's what War Dancers do. Dirty fucking nasty War Dancers. I bet you that all Wood Elf coaches, and Stouticus, I'm sorry if you get offended by this, I bet you that all Wood Elf coaches are happy that Chaos Dwarfs were released, because now there's a team people hate more than Wood Elves. Zeus, he just knocked out the fucking King of the Gods. Can you do that? Zeus just got popped. And a dub skull. He doesn't take the dub skull. He lets it go. Apparently he felt like he needed to cage. He did need to cage up a little bit more. Get this guard piece down here involved in protecting your ball carrier like that. I'm actually really impressed with both these coaches. This has been a fun match. I don't know if Stouticus, what if his plan is. I mean, he wants to score a touchdown on this guy because he's only got 4 SPP from his next level. Samuel Elm Jackson. It's the whitest Samuel Elm Jackson ever. I don't know if he's going to score here or what his plan is. Or if he wants to try and stall out. He can stall for at least another turn. But Owen needs to keep putting bodies down here. He needs to come crash these guys. And he needs, and when you're crashing this corner, which is exactly what you should be doing. That's unfortunate. There you go. Get the pal on Benedict Cumberbatch. And get the armor break. I'd foul that fucker. Oh, you're not in a good spot to foul him, unfortunately. So when Owen is crashing this corner, which is all well and good, I like it. He needs to make sure he has at least one guy over here. Because Wood Elves are really fast. And he can just fucking zoom over here and corner up over here. Which looks exactly what he's fucking doing. He's going to do a blitz with the ball carrier, which is gutsy. gets the knockdown, backs away. Yeah. So just as I was saying, you needed a body over here in case this exact scenario happens. Oh, man. Dodges away from tackle. It's only a 2+, but eventually he'll fell some of those. Poseidon, king of the sea, takes it in the chin. Probably because he's out of water. 3-9 from the tree. I like that. That was a nice play. Trees are strength 6, so they only need 2 assists for the 3-die. Or excuse me, 1 assist on an AV 3-piece. More dodging. That's what elves do. And he can just fucking play this back and forth game all day long. So Owen needs to make him score so he has enough time to equalize or to get the go-ahead score. Like, at this point, you know the Stouticus is scoring. There's another injury on Morgan. On Morgan Freeman. AV, so that guy's gone. He's going to get fired. AV7's bad. AV6 is really bad. The only regret I think that Owen has right now is he hasn't caused more damage. There you go. Kick him fucking word answers. That's what you got to do. Get him off the pitch. Failed. That sucks. But you didn't use your bribe, so you can keep fouling. One way to pressure a coach to score is you foul his important pieces, and then he scores to protect his important pieces in a better position. Like, if this guy had been stunned, Benedict Cumberbatch, if this guy had been stunned, he'd have scored right now. Because he's like, that guy's gonna, not only did he get fouled this turn, he's going to get fouled next turn. Now he can get away, right? So if that had been a stun, he would have scored, and then the Dwarfs would have had four turns to score. But since he didn't get a stun, he gets up and he runs away. But that means you can hit him again. Just keep hitting that guy. This is clearly his most important piece. He's a fucking move 9 ward answer with Mighty Blow. You need to keep focusing on hurting this dude. You can get 2 die on him? No, you can't. Well, you still can. Tree finally takes root. Still gets his 2 die. He's got... Oh, he doesn't have grab. Oh, no way. No wonder he did it differently than I did. That fucking tree doesn't have grab. I'm so used to every fucking tree having grab. He's unskilled. He doesn't have grab. The fucking dummy. Not used to it, because me. I'm the dummy. Just assumed he had grab. Oh. Because every tree I've ever seen has had grab. Every fucking tree ever. Alright, so here comes... Here comes the owned. He's gonna get at least a hit. Gotta hit this catcher. I like hitting catchers. Catchers are weak. Yeah, that's gonna be. He's got another turn of stall on him. Looks like. Benedict is gonna do some kicking with his mighty blow. He can stall another turn. This is a fucking good. This has been 2 really strong drives. Like I said, Stouticus doesn't need to score. I mean, he doesn't need to win. A draw keeps him in the same spot. There's 1-point lead going into the final week. So then a win will win it for him. And I think he's only lost 1 game. We'll check the standings afterwards. So this is a really good elf stall. And his offense, his defense was great too. Got the ball, almost had it out. Took some fancy dice by own. 2 good coaches. I'm enjoying this game. He's squeezing him out now, so now he might need to score next turn. We'll see. Knock down Robert Dogwoody Jr. with Mighty Blow. The fucking elf armor's been pretty solid. I mean, there is 2 permanents, but the elf armor's been really solid. And that's disappointing if you're the dwarfs with all this Mighty Blow. hitting this 87. Like, you really wanted to hurt someone. And fucking three bribes. Like, he's done a heavy fouling, which I love. I love the fucking fouling on Wood Elves. I think it's an awesome move. Look at him coming all the way in here at the GFI to hit this guy. I like that. He's only got one hit on him because he's a GFI. But he's putting pressure on it, which I like. Now this guy's going to have to score. And you're going to see the two-turn dwarf touchdown, which I have done. I have done. It is really fucking hard. But possible, especially since you have a move 7 guy. Samuel L. Jackson doing his fucking karate moves. And no kung fu. And his move 7 guy comes back, so this two-turner is possible, but you have to be ultra-aggressive. And it's going to be hard because elves. Oh, man. Every time an elf does some bullshitty thing, I just say, because elves. And everybody looks at me like, yep, that makes sense, because elves. So pick a side, go really hard. You need your move 7 guy needs to be on the line. And then this dude needs to catch the ball and throw it to him. And then he needs to set up a cage and score. Sounds super easy, right? He's going to do it on the left. I like this because most coaches go right, which means most people are used to defending the right. The only thing I don't like about this is that this war dancer, the nasty war dancer, is on the left. But the two movement guys are over here, so I changed my mind. I do like it because you're negating this move. Because if they're over here, they get to use their move. It's important, but over here, it's less important. Oh, another bribe. And this is actually important. This means that the dwarf coach and the elf coach, they can both foul both turns. I guess foul all day. If you're the dwarfs, if you're owned, and you're just getting a tie out of this, and it leaves you 1 point behind going last game, you need to do damage. Like, you need to knock one of these guys out, maybe get an MNG. Because if the weaker you make the coach Stouticus for his next game, better chance you have of winning. So the bribes are important. He needs to make sure that he fouls. I would have rerolled that. Well, you can't really reroll that because you need to do all this action back here. Especially the ball's not in a good spot. If this was going to be your scoring threat, and I think it was. So I don't like this. I don't like this because you're going to bring your dwarf over here and he's going to pick this ball up. And then all these elves can go get him. There's nobody protecting him. He's going to go for a Hail Mary pass. And with where that kick was, because Stouticus has a kick skill. Kick skill is awesome on fucking Wood Elves. Because of where that kick was, a red die. That's unlucky there. Unlucky to get double skulls. When you have luck and your opponent doesn't, going uphill isn't bad. And the reroll doesn't matter because he only has one turn left, so it's okay to reroll there too. The unfortunate part is you don't get knock anybody down to fucking use your bribe. But no, he's a favorite there. Going uphill with no block with a reroll, he's definitely a favorite. That's a good move. He's covering this guy because this is the scoring threat. Because the only scoring threat, reroll to knock him down. King of the Gods is gone again. Apo that. I don't know why he Apo that. There's no reason to Apo this because the Apo just turns him into a stun and then he'll be stunned on your last turn. So, yeah, hopefully one of these guys doesn't take an injury. So what's Owen needs to do is he needs to go in, he needs to clear one of these two guys. The real Hail Mary player is, there's two ways to do it. You go up here as far as you can and you throw the ball to this guy and then you have him blitz this dude off and then go score. The other option is to blitz this guy off first and then dodge out. Which one's better? I'd say coach's preference. Because this guy's AG3, I think I like blitzing the guy off first because it makes this right now is a 5+ catch. If you blitz him off first, then it's a 4+ catch. And so, yeah. There you go. I mean, throw's going to be a 6 anyway. And he should have put this guy on the tack on this. This guard piece needs to be on top of this guy. I mean, it just makes the dodges more. It's too, I mean, he's just making the dodges more difficult, right? Once he gets to, if he, this guy gets away, he's got to do these crazy dodges. If he puts him on the ball carrier is not going to catch the ball. You don't have to worry about him getting hit because he's got to go for the throw. I mean, foul this fucking tree. I don't know if he had anybody left, but if he did, he should have fouled that tree. Oh, this is really the tree fucked up. I'm sorry. The tree won 9 there. I'd foul the tree. Foul the tree. I'd have hit this fucking. Yeah. Well, this is good. That's exactly the way I would have done it. Except for. That's fine. You go there and there. Go up here. I foul the tree first. Foul the tree first. Oh. So he must have been a 5 plus trying to get into a 4 plus. Now you use your reroll. I don't know why he did both of them. He gets the pass. Does he get the catch? He gets the catch. Holy shit. Oh, no. That was going to be a fucking hero play. Oh, that was fucking great. All right, man. Fun game. Really fucking good game. I should pay more attention to fucking Division 6, I guess. This is a fucking fun game. This armor busted guy gets the MVP. Morgan Freeman. That sucks because he's going to get fired anyway. This guy, Poseidon, he's one more MVP away from Stand Firm or Mighty Blow. Let's check out SVP first. Looks like 11 there for Berserkers with that fucking throw by Apollo at the end, God of the Sun. And the wooden stand-ins, the fucking Wood Elves, they're only getting 9. Benedict Cumberbatch. This is a fucking fun game, man. He's really well done by both coaches. This awesome stall, that awesome stall by the wooden stand-ins. Means that they had the more ball position. 41 blocks to 32. Well, this is, I mean, 1 injury, 1 K, 2 KOs, and 1 kill. You were hoping for more than that. That all looks normal. So, well done by both coaches. I really enjoyed that game. Let's check out the leaderboard real fast. So, wooden stand-ins have 29, and the Berserkers have 28. So, yeah, 1 point difference. Berserkers are undefeated. Damn. Nice job, owned. This guy's right behind him. This fucking Brazzers. Brazzers is a porn site, in case you didn't know. Yeah. Superfed TV. So he's at 21. He's at 24. So he'll go up. He'll relegate up or promote up, but he won't. It's between these two. DiZarino, this guy right here, worked New York Mafia. This is an old Division One coach. He was Division One last year. And he forgot to sign up. And he did it the first season, too. He always forgets to sign up, so then the admin's got to find a spot for him. So it looks like he re-rolled into an orc team, and he's still finding his way with the orcs, but he's a really fucking cool guy. Killsaber, I'm in a division with Killsaber, too. Was in another league with him. I might be in 2 leagues with him, actually. Nice guy. He streams his game, so you can learn a lot by watching him. Entertaining. Entertaining to watch. Watch his stream. So let's see what do the wooden stand-ins have next week in the ultimate game. This is an important one. Pikey Park, which is Killsaber, the one we just talked about. So Killsaber's Pikey Park. He's Wood Elves, or excuse me, Dark Elves. Maybe he's not playing. No, I think I'm sure he's playing because I saw him streaming. So let's check out his squad real fast. Pikey Park. There you go. Dark Elves. 1340. Looks like no witches yet. That sucks. Sucks, these runners. This is not a very well-developed team. So that's going to be a tough matchup for Killsaber. He looks like he's had a rough season. Probably rebuilding a bunch of these guys. Boris the Blade. Boris the Bullet Tooth Tony. Oh, I get it now. Mickey O'Neill. This is all off of Snatch. The movie Snatch. That's cool. Turkish. Turkish is a runner. That's great. I would have had Frankie Fourfinger. He's probably a good lineman. They call him Fourfinger, so they gave him the chop. So that's going to be a tough game. So that probably means Berserkers is going to miss the playoffs. But not by lack of trying. 1 point, man. At one point, who does he get next week? Let's see the schedule. Berserkers, Oathblow. How is Oathblow doing? Where are you at, Oathblow? There you are. I'm 5th, Norse. 6-2-3 is a good squad right here. My crown jelly. Check out Oathblow for a real quick one. Looks like he's got a level up, so I'm sure that Eisen Mike probably didn't give a shit about that. I've never watched a 4-6 recap. Eisen Mike doesn't like to level his guys, so he probably doesn't give people shit for not leveling those dudes. But if he was in Division 1-3, fucking Sace, he hates it when people don't level their guys. This is a good looking squad, though. Lots of tackle. Jesus. 1, 2, 3, 4 tackles. This must be an elf heavy fucking division for if you're carrying that much tackle. Two throwers. Some people do that, some people don't. He's got two. This guy's got leader, so he's got 3 rerolls and leader. Crown Jelly, you should either fire this guy, just fire them all together, because you don't necessarily need 2 throwers, or number reroll. You're carrying extra TV that you don't need to, and you don't need that many rerolls, especially as your Norse, because you have all this block. He's got a move busted runner, but he's got blodge. I'd fire this guy too. He's got enough money, I'd fire him and rehire him. This is your best player. I can see that he's your best player, but he's got move bust and he's a runner. fucking Norse don't go that fast, so I would think you wanted all your speed. This guy got dodge. I probably still would have gotten mighty blow even though I got the doubles, but I'm not a Norse coach by any stretch of the imagination. This is a Norse team with no mighty blow. So I don't get it. You should have some mighty blow. Anyway, great game. Stouticus and Berserker. Really, really enjoyed that game. My first foray into Division 6. So, yeah. Thank you for watching, guys. See you.